Welcome to Latin Classics Concert Series. And here we are again in this beautiful St. Aldegonde's Church of Durlen in St. Martin's Latin. Today we have a very special concert in memoriam of an artist, great musician, one of the best cellists I know, winner of the biggest competitions of the world, and a unique person, Alexander Buzlov. He left us exactly 4 months ago at the age of 37. Our hearts are with his family and his incredible wife, Alisa Margulis, and their young daughter. We are starting our concert with the minute of silence. We're not going to talk, but we are going to play. Chopin, Nocturne. The next part of our concert is a unique combination of music and art. Especially for this occasion, an artist, Bezwierzchni van Gent, created paintings which are inspired by pictures at an exhibition of Modest Mussorgsky. It's one of his most remarkable works for piano. The cycle consists of several music pieces, which are based on the paintings of great Victor Hartmann, incredible artist, a good friend of the composer himself. He suddenly died at the age of 39, and this great work was composed in his remembrance of Victor Hartmann. Pictures at an exhibition, it's a journey between life and death. Prominent, it's an observation of this journey. The first picture is gnome. It's a mystical creature which materialize in different corners of a dark room. It's the fear of unknown. The next picture is the old castle, Il Vecchio Castello. It's a medieval Italian castle. It appears as an illusion, as a ghost, and then it vanishes. Children quarrel after games. The name of this picture speaks for itself, but a very clear connection with the darkest picture of the cycle makes us questioning the innocence of it. Bydło. It's a Polish cart with enormous wheels pulled by oxen. It's a cart with a coffin, and the whole funeral procession comes from far away. It comes closer and closer, and it makes screams, tears, and pain real, and after it disappears. Ballet of Unhatched Chicks. There is a very clear connection with one of the most demonic pieces of the cycle, The Witch. And this is Ballet of Dead Chicks. The next picture is Samuel Holdenberg and Schmule. Two Jewish men, poor and rich. They appear as a contradiction to each other, but at the end, they're standing side by side at the verge of death. Limoges, the market, the great news. French women quarrel violently in the market, and the quarrel drops us into the darkness of the next picture. Catacombs. It's a journey through Paris catacombs with its noises, sighs, light, and darkness. With the dead in a dead language. I have to refer to our artist, Bezwierzchni van Gent. He told me that every year he has less and less people next to him at the table at the holidays because they're not anymore with us. But still, every New Year's Eve, he puts the plates and the glasses on their places and celebrates with their souls because they're still all in our hearts. Baba Yaga. That's a witch in Russian. Here, this picture is the rebellion of darkness, The Witch's Flight. In the capital of Kyiv, the city gates. That's our final picture of the cycle. It impresses with its massive style and power. The bell, which clearly appears in the middle, refers us to an amazing opera of Modest Mussorgsky, Boris Godunov, and it's a funeral bell.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Sergei Rachmaninoff, Trio Elegiac No. 1. It has its clear connection with the great piano trio of Tchaikovsky, which was written in the memory of a great artist. This is our tribute to a great artist. Thank you.
Thank you.